Let us look at how we can convert the number of particles to masses. For example, given how many grams of calcium are contained in part A, 6.0 × 10⁻³ atoms, part B, 1.5 × 10⁻³ atoms. Let us find the solution. We're going to do this using first principles, and I told you from first principles, we put what is unknown on the right hand side, then what is known on the left hand side. So, part A, we know that 6.02 × 10⁻², particles, this time we have atoms of are contained in 1 mole of calcium. But this time around, they are not asking for moles, they are asking for a mass in grams. So you are going to replace this 1 mole with mass. And remember, at the beginning, we said 1 mole of a substance is equal to the relative atomic mass. And you know that the relative atomic mass of calcium is 40. So, RIM of calcium is equal to 40. So, any mass is, or the molecular mass is 40 grams. So, I'm going to replace the 1 mole with the mass. So, 6.02 × 10³ atoms are contained in 40 grams of calcium. Therefore, if 6.0 atoms are contained in 40 grams of calcium, what would be one atom? So the mass of one atom is contained in, of course, multiply 1 × 40 divided by this number here is 1 × 40 divided by 6.02 × 10³ grams of calcium. Then, having known this, what was the required number of atoms? There were 6.02 × 10⁻³ atoms. So the 6.02 × 10³ atoms are contained in cross multiply again this and this over this. But since this is one, you can leave it out. So it's like half. Cross multiply this and this, 1 × 40 over 6.02 × 10⁻³, then times 6.02 × 10⁻³. The whole of this is in grams. When you look at this, this can cancel out with that, remaining 40 grams of calcium. As simple as that. Part B, we're going to find the mass of calcium that is contained by 1.5 × 10⁻³ atoms. Part B, using the Avogadro's number, that is 6.02 × 10⁻³, that is contained in 1 mole of a substance, that is 6.02 × 10⁻³. These atoms are contained in 1 mole of calcium. So this is the Avogadro's number. So we are going to replace the 1 mole with the relative atomic mass, as I told you before, that relative atomic mass of calcium is 40 and is also equal to 1 mole of calcium. Therefore, 6.02 times 10 power 23 atoms are contained in 40 grams of calcium. Having known that, we can find now the mass of one atom. Therefore, one atom is contained in, cross multiply, 1 times this divided by the Avogadro's number, 1 times 40 divided by Avogadro's number, which is 6.02, then 10 power 23 grams of calcium. Again, we are going to cross multiply because we need to find the mass that is contained by this number of atoms. The 1.5 times 10 power 23 atoms are contained in, cross multiply again, this time with this divided by 1, so 1 over 6.02 times 10 power 23, then times 40, again times 1.5 times 10 power 23 atoms. So when you put that on your calculator, of course you are going to get 10 grams of calcium. Let us look at example 2. Calculate the mass of sodium with 1.5 times 10 power 22 atoms. They are giving us sodium as 23, that is the RIM. Then they are giving us L. L simply means Avogadro's constant. It is the same to show Avogadro's constant, which is 6.02 times 10 power 23. So, solution. We can write the Avogadro's constant for the relative atomic mass by saying that 6.02 times 10 power 23 atoms are contained in 1 mole of sodium. So, we know that 1 mole of sodium is equal to 23 grams. So, I can replace the 1 mole with the 23. Therefore, I say 6.02 times 10 power 23 atoms are contained in 23 grams of sodium. Now, if 6.02 times 10 power 23 atoms are contained in 23 grams, what of the 1 gram, 1 atom? That one atom is contained in, you cross multiply 1 times 23 divided by the Avogadro constant, which is 1 times 23 divided by 6.02 times 10 power 23. What of the required number of atoms? 1.5 times 10 power 22, therefore 1.5 then 10 power 22 atoms are contained in, cross multiply again, this times this divided by that is 1 times 22, 23 divided by 6.02 times 10 power 23, then times the 1.5 times 10 power 22. When you put this into the calculator, we are going to get 0.575 grams. We are now looking at converting moles to masses. When converting moles to masses, there are two important things to note here. Number one, 1 mole of a substance, 1 mole of a substance for an element is equal to the relative atomic mass. For example, 1 mole of copper is equal to 64. 1 mole of nitrogen, nitrogen is equal to 14. And note number two, one mole of a molecule is equal to the relative formula mass or the relative molecular mass. For example, we have one mole of water is equal to 18. Then we have one mole of copper sulfate is equal to 160. So you have examples here. Calculate the mass in 0.23 moles of sodium, part B, 7.1 moles of chlorine molecules, part C, 0.1 moles of potassium carbonate. Apply the solution. Part A, 0.23 moles of sodium. I told you, we put what is known to the left hand side, then what is unknown on the right hand side. This time around, we know the number of moles, and we need to know the mass contained by this number of moles. Therefore, we put the number of moles on the left hand side, then the mass on the right hand side. Now that one mole of sodium weighs, they're giving us sodium here, it's 23 grams. Now, if one mole of sodium weighs 23 grams, what of the 0.23 moles of sodium weigh? You cross multiply this times this, divide by 1, which is 0.23 times 23 over 1. The whole of this is grams. When you put this one into the calculator, you shall get 5.2 grams sodium. That is our part 1. In part B, they are telling us to find the mass of 7.1 moles of chlorine molecules. So half chlorine molecules as an atomic molecule, like that. So we are supposed to find the relative formula mass of chlorine, which is, they're giving us chlorine here, the RIM, that 5.5. Then how many are there? There are 2, and multiply by 2. When you multiply this, we shall get 71. So we're supposed to find the mass of this, of those moles there. So we say one mole of chlorine molecule weighs 71 grams. Then if one mole weighs 71 grams, what of the required number of moles here? The 7.1 moles. 7.1 moles of chlorine where you cross multiply 7.1 times 71, 7.1 times 71 divided by 1. The whole of this is in grams. When you try to put this into the calculator, you are going to get 504 on each 1 grams. In part C, we are supposed to find the number of the mass that is contained by 0.1 moles of potassium carbonate. The formula for potassium carbonate is that. So supposed to find the RFM of potassium carbonate. Potassium, they are giving us 39. There are 2 of them. Then plus carbon is 12 times 1. Again plus oxygen is 16 times 3. When you try to multiply, you are going to get 48 here. Then plus 12. Again here we have, this is 8. This is 78. The answer will be 138 grams. So therefore we say one mole of potassium carbonate weighs 138 grams. Now if one mole weighs this 180 grams. What of the 0.1 moles, the required number of moles is 0.1 moles of calcium carbonate, where the cross multiply 0.1 and 1.8 divided by 1 is 1.8 and 0.1 divided by 1. The whole of this is grams of potassium carbonate. When you pull this one to a calculator, you're going to get 13.8 grams of potassium carbonate. As simple as that. Now we are looking at converting masses to moles.